Hey guys, so yesterday it was reported that New York Yankees outfielder Chris Anderson is going to be out for at least 10 weeks due to a fractured forearm. Now, over the last few hours, I've been reading the rumor sheet to see who the Yankees could possibly acquire. And the names that they come up with are Brandon Wild and Alfonso Soriano. And that's not the type of player the Yankees want, considering that they have $189 million cap to hold on to. Think they want to be under the luxury tax for 2014. Now, that got me thinking, who could the Yankees possibly acquire that keep and could also produce in Granderson's absence while not having a problem going to the bench after he comes back? Now, only one name kept popping into my mind. A lot of East Coast fans may not know him because he's on the West Coast, and that's Geraldo Parra from the Arizona Diamondbacks. Now, for the majority of his career, he's been a fourth outfielder, but when he's gotten a chance to play, he's shown some bright spots. I'm just going to give you his stats for the last 2 years. Last year, in 385 at bats, he had 7 homers and 36 RBIs while batting .273. The year before that, in 445 at back, he had 8 homers and 46 RBIs with a batting average of .292. So, he's shown some breakbacks. The only problem is he hasn't gotten a chance to play consistently. And I think that with Curtis Granderson out for at least a month or two, that'll show what he's made of. And it will show if he's a major league player. And he's gonna become a free agent in 2016, and that's relatively cheap if you consider that the Yankees will only be paying $2.375 million for him this year. And I think if you give him a shot, he could show what he's made of. And you may be asking, who would I be trading? And the ideal candidate for this trade is Jabba Chamberlain. Now, Jabba has been going through some struggles over the last couple of years. In 2012, he had a 4.35 ERA, pitched horribly in 22 games. In 2011, in 27 games, he had a 2.83 ERA, 24 strikeouts, and allowed 3 homers. So I can give Gabagek a change of scenery. I think he could do well. Plus, I don't think the Yankees ballpark is conducive to him and how he pitches. He's a hard grower that if you make contact on the ball, it's probably gonna go a long way. Okay guys, so tell me what you think about this video. Peace.